In this video, I will take you along a week in my studio, which is not really a studio, it's just a corner in the living room. But this is where I create all my garments and also do all the computer work. So it's a small space, but I have utilized it to the maximum. Still, it comes with certain limitations, but I guess we all have to face those limitations. What I'm working on right now is developing the next garment sewing pattern. And it's a very exciting time because the actual pattern is done. What we're doing now is working on the sizing. So my pattern maker has graded all the sizes. I'm definitely a bit nervous now because we are going to see if the expansion of the size range, which I'm doing right now, because I have increased and added 3 more sizes. I have a friend that is a size 56, so I'm going to create a sample for her and send it to her via mail because she doesn't live in another city. And because right now we're still in the pandemic, so even if I had a person here locally in that size, I would kind of still not be able to be that in close contact with that person. So today, what we're going to do now is that I am going to prep the raw files that I've gotten from my pattern maker. Those are done in pattern drafting software. And now, because I need to print them out on my own, like small printer. So yeah, now you know what's happening today. So I am going to pour myself some more coffee, put up my computer and raise my desk to become a standing desk. And well, it's time to start working. This is the sleeve for size 56, and now I'm going to do the full bicep adjustment. This is a first for me. I have not done this before, but I have a good book. This one, Fit for Real People. I will link that in the description section, but I'm sure many of you are already familiar with this. This is one of the fitting book classics, I would say. It's by Patty Palmer and Marta Aalto. And there's a new edition as well, which I don't have, but I've heard really good things about that as well. But I'm just going to follow the exact instructions for the full arm adjustment, they call it here, but it's also called full biceps adjustment. So what you're doing basically is that you are slicing up the cap here to create more width. So if your arms are a little bit bigger than what the pattern is based upon, this is a good adjustment to do, and I know it's a quite popular adjustment that a lot of people want to do. So now I am going to do this myself for my friend, and again, as I said, also learn something in the process myself. You may be wondering, why am I leaning on top of a iron board? I always forget this. People keep telling me and I keep forgetting it. There's two ways of saying iron, right? You can iron something, and you also have iron, right? Which is like the metal. And I never remember which one you are supposed to pronounce the R and which one you're supposed to not pronounce the R. So please tell me in the comment section, and I will do my best to remember it the next time. But this is so annoying because I keep checking it out which one is which, and then when I'm speaking, I forget. Anyways. If you look behind me here, You can see now that on the cutting table is actually the sample that I am sewing for my pattern that I just talked about. But then I realized that I'm also currently working on a pair of jeans. So of course, you know, all my sewing machines are set up for jeans making. And if you're like me, and I'm sure I know many of you can relate, is the fact that it's such a bummer to set up your sewing machine for different things when you have it like set it up for a certain type of project, which is why I don't really usually do many projects at once. I only work on one project and then I finish that and then I do something else. So meaning that I was like, okay, I could cut this out, of course, and I will today, but I would also like to finish the jeans. So that means I have plenty more to do. So realistically, I would probably not be able to finish the jeans today, even though I like dedicated my day to it. If I start to sew, it's basically like throwing myself into this vortex and time and space just disappears, which means that I need to start doing the kind of slightly more boring admin task right now. Before I do that, because if I start sewing right now in the before lunch, the rest of the day will be completely lost. I'm sure you can relate, but I just get into the zone and then I forget everything. I forget to like go up and, you know, move around, eat. I'm getting much better with this, you know, trying to take care of myself while I get in those sewing frenzies, but I still have this tendency about myself, and you know, it's just who I am. I'm not really trying to fight it now. I know that I have this personality, so that's why, as I said, I need to like structure my day a little bit around that, knowing that once I start working on these jeans, it's bye bye, you know, everything else. It's Wednesday, and I'm sure you're curious of how did it go with those jeans that I plan to make. Well, I'm happy to report that they are actually finished. So this is how they look like. And the actual initial sewing, that went quite well. Of course, a lot of ripping, you know, with the top stitching. I'm pretty particular about that. But the big bummer that happened was that, because I'm, for context now, you guys, is that I am completely like redrafting my like basic jeans pattern to accommodate for my changing bodies as I age, right? So what happened was that I have changed the waistband style and the waistband, how it fits and how it drafted, because I need more space at the waist right now. And all it seemed okay when I was doing like the initial fitting, but then of course when I have sewn all the pieces together, there was some gaping in the back. Not much, but it was kind of enough to kind of annoy me, you know, and I always have this like inner battle. Maybe you can relate, but sometimes I just want to be like, okay, I can ignore this, but then I know it will annoy me. So I had this internal like battle. Should I just wear a belt and, you know, go on with my day, or should I re-sew the waistband and basically cut it open in the back and redo the crotch yoke and waistband area in the back? And of course, you know that when you're making jeans, right, you've done all the top stitching and, you know, it's a lot of ripping. But then I was like, I will be annoyed by this. So this morning, before I start recording this vlog, I went back, ripped up the entire back area, And just cut away the surplus fabric, redid the top stitching, and redid the waistband. So now they're actually done. There's a little bit of a bummer because you can see here that there in the back there is kind of like it's like a little bit slanted in the behind. That's because I did this like a quick fix, right? So that was but the pants fits really well, and I'm super happy how they turned out. So all in all, it was a good experience. So now that the jeans are on the way, maybe I can finally be able to start sewing the sample for the pattern that I am creating. I will of course now do the sample, and today also among my plans is to start drafting the illustrations for the pattern instructions. And that takes quite a lot of time. And if you, for instance, have my Alla Leggings pattern, you will see that I do quite detailed step-by-step instructions, which means that I have to create tons and tons and tons of illustrations just to make sure that every step is clearly illustrated. I actually love doing this, but it takes so much time. And I think for this pattern, I will probably have to do around about 50 or 60 illustrations. I might remove a few, but I definitely want to have the options to make that very like, so every step is actually illustrated. No step will be unillustrated, basically. And then of course, photos are also nice to have. So my plan for this pattern as well is just like I did with the Isla leggings, that I will also provide a step-by-step sew along the blog where I show some techniques, and then of course I will use photos. So it's a tricky thing to figure out what is the best way. So hopefully, and also I will probably do some videos showing some techniques as well. So hopefully by combining the illustrations, the photos on the tutorials, and the some videos as well, which I have done with other stuff that I put out, hopefully this will be enough for you to be able to fully follow the process. So that's what I'm trying to do today now. Cut the fabric, and then it's computer work all day doing illustrations. But enough about that. Now let's head over to the cutting table, which I have done a separate video about, or maybe two, or maybe three. If you're curious, it's basically an IKEA hack. So there are shelves that I've put on wheels, and then a firm tree slab over all that. So if you want to know about that, you can definitely check out those other videos that I've done about my cutting setup. But now let's start cutting and see how that goes. Yes, I have finally cut out this sample. This basically took me 3 days to get to this point. The actual cutting though was really quick, because this is actually a fairly quick and easy make, even though it has some really fun and interesting details. So that was very rewarding to finally have these cut up, and I will now start sewing the sample. As for when the pattern will be released, who knows, to be honest right now, because if there's anything this last year has taught us, is that we cannot really predict anything, right? So I honestly have no idea exactly when it will be out, but hopefully not too long from now. Another thing that I also wanted to update about is that I'm actually going through a big change right now, meaning that among other things, that I will have more time to devote to the last stitch in 2021. Some of you already know this probably, but I've been doing this as a part-time thing on top of my day job, which means that I've been quite busy and of course also been quite exhausted, to be honest, especially this last year. But things are about to change, and I will do a video about that where I go all into all the details and talk about my plans. But if you're curious and want to know what I am talking about, I've already done a blog post about it. So if you head over to thelaststitch.com, I will of course link to that post in the description section of this video too. You can actually check out what I am talking about. But as I said, I will also do a video where I talk more about what's been going on in my life and what's happening now in 2021. So some shocking stuff for me personally. I hadn't expected that to happen in the beginning of 2020, but I do think that all things considered, it will be the thing that will actually turn out to be quite beneficial when, well, all things are considered. So yeah, that's what's been going on in my life. I hope you enjoy this type of video. And if you want to see more peeks behind the scene of what it's like to run a small sewing business, please drop me a comment on things you like me to cover. And well, I think that's about it, right? So I talk to you soon. Stay safe.